Hi everyone, it's Anime Rose, and I'm here with the wonderful, the beloved...
Telly from The Word Alive.
Slay. So, how's it going so far on the 2016 Vans Warped Tour?
It's pretty great. I'm a little over a week in now, and the last of three Florida shows, it's been great so far. Hopefully today will be the same.
In March, you released your latest album, Dark Matter. Phenomenal, by the way. I loved it. Why is this album special in comparison to your previous ones? Not to say that the other ones aren't special, but, you know, like, what makes it even better?
I mean, for us, we got to that point in our career where, you know, we're a little bit older. We've kind of, like, settled into, like, where we want to go. This is actually the first album, or the first time where we'd had the same lineup for two consecutive albums with writing included. And I think that made a big difference, and we just spent the most time we ever have with writing and recording. We locked ourselves away and just really put forth the extra effort in every category to make sure that each song was, like, unanimously a good song within the band. And so we feel pretty proud, you know, about it.
You have a favorite song off the album?
It changes all the time. I mean, of the three that we're playing on Warped right now, we're playing Made This Way, Sell Out, and Trapped. And, like, to me, those three are so different, but they're each just as fun for me to play. A song that's on the sampler, actually, for Warped Tour Dreamer, the first track on the album, is one of my favorite songs. So, yeah, any one of those and beyond.
Since you're currently obviously on the Warped Tour, what would you say is the best part of being on Warped Tour?
I mean, either the shows or just, like, especially this year, we have so many friends who are also on the tour. And just, like, the time you get to spend with your friends for 2 months straight. And, you know, it's rare. It's longer than a normal tour is, obviously. So you get to spend, especially some of our friends that we've known for 6 to 10 years, it's really rad to just be able to hang out with them on a weekly basis for a couple months.
Have you had any crazy or memorable in some way experiences with fans?
Nothing too crazy this year. We've had a couple wheelchair crowd surfs, which is always really sick to see. That's probably, like, I mean, that's crazy in a good way. We haven't had anything too crazy, though, this year. It's been pretty mellow.
That's good.
Yeah.
There have been some stories. Okay, so what would you say are the biggest obstacles that bands face today?
I mean, survival. No one wants to pay for music anymore. The financial side of music, which, you know, everyone can sit there and say, like, oh, you know, you should love what you do, and if you love what you do, like, you should be fine with whatever that is. Well, you know, when bands who love what they do are coming home and they can barely eat, can't pay rent, can't pay their cell phone bills to keep in touch with their family members that they're gone away, 7, 10, or, you know, or even some crazy people more than that away from their families, it's like, you know, at what point do we stop the cycle that's, like, really hurting the artists? And it's not even just music, you know, it's all the people who are involved with music to a certain extent. And, you know, unfortunately, money is something that drives this industry, and you have to have money to be able to go on tour, to be able to record an album, to be able to print merch so that your fans can, you know, not only support you, but then also represent the band and hopefully spread the word about you. You know, at this point, like, with the way things are kind of going, it's just making it harder and harder for bands to be bands and tour, which is what I think fans want, you know. But if it gets to the point where they have to stream shows and they can't tour because, you know, fans aren't paying enough to warrant bringing them, and unfortunately, because so much emphasis is put on things like first week numbers and how many albums have you sold, well, no one's buying albums like they used to. So it's like a very select few that are doing well. But even that, like Drake, for instance, like one of the biggest selling artists, you know, over the last 5 years, if he was doing what he's doing right now, even 10 years ago, it would be astronomically beyond what it is. In Adele, like, you know, breaking like records 10 years ago, she might have had the biggest album of all time. Like, it's just one of those things where even the best are like significantly lower than what it's been the last 5 years. So I don't know. It's kind of scary, you know, being in a van right now, but we're just making our way through it the best we can and trying to write good music, and hopefully that trumps the decline of music sales.
So what would you say it is that keeps you and the rest of the band motivated to keep going?
Well, I mean, we do ultimately love what we do. We love, you know, making music, playing shows, creating. It's an important part of all of our lives. And I think, you know, just the drive to be better, to make better music, to continue to top what we've done. And obviously, like, our hope is that we can grow and have shows that, you know, are very special for us, you know, our crew, our family members, and obviously the fans.
In regards to special shows and pleasing your fans, is there any show in particular recently that you could say has been killer, or that one really stuck out?
Two on this tour have been like above the rest, and that'd be Orlando and Atlanta. They're like pretty similar in like the crowd reaction, and size of the crowd was just massive. So probably those two have really stuck out. I mean, we're just, you know, very fortunate to, this is our, well, we've done Warped Tour, this will be our fourth year, but the first year was half a year, but so we've done it several times, and each year it keeps growing and growing, and this year's been no exception, so we're just really thankful for that.
Now, do you think it's okay if we play a little game?
Sure.
Alright, sounds good. I'm gonna do a Would You Rather game. So, obviously, I say one thing or another, and you choose which one you would rather do.
Okay.
So the first one is, would you rather win a board game at the last possible second, or win the board game by landslide?
Last possible second.
Keep them waiting. Ride shotgun or be in control of the music?
Be in control of the music.
I think that would be the go-to.
Yeah.
Okay. Be someone's best friend or be the favorite child?
Best friend.
Okay. Not be allowed to eat your favorite 5 foods for a year, or only be allowed to eat your favorite 5 foods for a whole year?
Only.
Only? Really? Yeah. You wouldn't get like sick and tired of it?
I pretty much do that already, so.
Okay, makes sense. Would you rather be permanently bald or always have floor-length hair?
Bald.
You can put wigs. It's clearly the better option. Live without electricity for a week or live without running water for a week?
Electricity.
You could live without all the gadgets and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. Okay, this one is my personal favorite. Would you rather be attacked by 50 duck-sized horses or one horse-sized duck?
The duck-sized horses. Yeah, but they're small. A giant duck could literally just eat me.
Okay. Would you rather know the date of your death or know the cause of your death?
That's a hard one. Date.
Okay. Would you rather speak all foreign languages fluently or be able to speak to animals?
Oh. I love my dog a lot. I would love to know what she's thinking, but I have to go with fluent in all languages.
I mean, maybe animal is a language, so you could work a loophole when you're working.
I think, like, you know, if I was the whole Dr. Dolittle thing, I mean, I saw how that went for a little bit. They tried to put him in a loony bin, so I'd rather just play it safe and just sit in on conversations anywhere in the world, and they would never think I could speak it and bust it out.
Shoot fire or shoot ice?
I don't know if one has a... I'll just say fire.
Really, here on Warped Tour, you're like sweating every day. You wouldn't choose ice?
It's not that bad.
Okay. Well, I don't know. I mean, I live in Florida and I just can't take it. Okay, would you rather have legs as long as your fingers or fingers as long as your legs?
I mean, I guess my fingers as long as my legs, but I would definitely amputate. And because you can shorten that, but you can't really do much about little hands. That would just be creepy. It'd be like a human, like, well, not octopus, because there's 10, but that would just be weird. I don't like that.
And the last one, would you rather never have internet access or always have Nicolas Cage within 3 feet of you?
Always have Nicolas Cage within 3 feet.
You sound very enthusiastic, like you want him to be.
So we have, like, you know those celebrity pillows with, like, faces on them? In my house, we have a Nicolas Cage one, and we do, like, Nick Cage marathons. So, yeah, that was an easy one.
Thank you so much for spending these few minutes with me and answering my questions and playing this little game. It's been an honor.
No problem.